So, good morning to all of you.
Good morning, sir.
So, today I will discuss about the nutrient requirement and feeding of dogs and cats. So, under this topic, I will discuss in detail about the what are the nutrients which are required for dog and cat and how we can manage the feeding of dog and cat and what are the supplements which are being used for feeding of dog and cats. So there are, as we are aware about that, you all know there are six basic nutrients which are required for everyone that age: carbohydrate, protein, fat, minerals, vitamins and water. These are six basic nutrients, and I will discuss here one by one in respect of the these nutrients for dog and cat requirement. So first I will discuss about the carbohydrate requirement. Carbohydrate is the sugar source of carbohydrate is sugar, starch and dietary fibers mainly. And dietary fibers, which are complex in nature and they are not easily digestible by the system of monogastric especially, and they are digested to some extent, but it is also essential for maintaining the gastrointestinal tract health and other purposes, and also reducing the toxicity of some compounds. So fiber is also essential in the diet of cat and dog. So the source of carbohydrate which are coming from major source, that is from the cereal grains, sugars, milk is also one of the important source, and beet pulp. Generally the pet owners, they are using beet pulp to feed their pets. And when excess carbohydrate fed to the pet, that may be stored in the form of glycogen or animal starch, commonly known as animal starch. So glycogen is stored in the liver as well as in muscle tissues. And when the animals are under fasting or a stress condition or not getting much of the food, or when they are doing exercise, then under such condition glycogen is used as a source of energy, or that will be converted to glucose by different cycles. So though the pet animals, generally pet owners provide cooked food to the pets, to their pets, and this is the one of the economical source of the energy. And some cases the sugars are palatable in dogs, but in case of cat, they do not respond to the taste of the sugar. We are talking only about the sugars. So cat are not responding taste of the sugars, but dog can. And the activity of intestinal disaccharide declines with time. That means when the age is increasing, we are talking especially about the lacto. So lactose is the disaccharides. The activity of intestine is decreasing when the age is increasing. Therefore, sucrose and lactose containing food product or food items that may leads to diarrhea in case of dog or pets. So we should cautious about the concentration of lactose and sucrose when feeding to the diet to the pet. Now coming to the fibers, which is the part of the carbohydrates, and the dietary fiber is also very much essential and that have numerous effect, different effect within the gastrointestinal tract. And a fiber which has capability of holding water, and they have fibers have high water holding capacity. That means that leads to easy passage of the digestive present in the GI tract, and simultaneously they are bulky in nature. So bulkiness of fiber may cause a stomach distension. So once the distension of a stomach starts or occurs in case of pet, then they feel like their stomach is full and they reduce the intake of the feed. So this is the negative part of the fiber. So they reduce the intake of feed and they also decrease the digestion and absorption of fat in case of pet, as well as they also decrease the digestion of vitamins and minerals as well. And fiber can, the good effect of fiber, they can bind to some toxins or metabolites that will be produced inside the system during the digestion. So they bind some toxin and prevent their absorption by the system. So they can protect the animals by binding these toxins. However, excess fiber, dietary fiber, which is associated with, that means which cause some common problem in case of pet, like when we feed excess dietary fiber, the pet there may be different kind of the condition which may occur, like loose stools, flatulence, increase stool volume and their frequency, as well as decrease dietary calorie density in case of pet when we feed excess dietary fiber in the diet of the pet, or include excess dietary fiber in the diet of the pet. So there may arise some problem. Now coming to the protein. So dietary protein is one of the most costliest item, or cost is very much high of the protein. And this dietary protein that will be digested in the stomach as well as small intestine. So they are forming from the amino acids. So they're broken down into amino acid, that free amino acid available after digestion, and that amino acid will be absorbed in the system or circulation, that will be utilized for building of the body tissues. And out of 22 amino acids, the 10 are essential for dog. 10 amino acids are essential for dog, and the name of those amino acids are arginine, histidine, isoleucine, leucine, lysine, methionine, phenylalanine, threonine, tryptophan and valine. So these 10 essential amino acids are essential for dog. However, in case of cat, the another amino acid which is dietary essential, that is taurine. So taurine is also essential in case of cat, and if deficiency of taurine occurs in cat, they may have different bad effect. So taurine must be supplemented, or the source of taurine must be supplemented in case of cat. That is difference between the dog and cat amino acid requirement. So the protein requirement, which depends on the stage of life and the activity of the pet. So pet, what if they are doing some activity, they are doing some exercise, they are doing some other work, we can take from the pet. So the activity of the pet and the stage of the life, will affect the protein requirement, and the requirement of protein will depend on these activity and life stage, means age of the pets. Like puppy means a small dog or puppy that needs more protein when we compare with the adult dog. And severe protein deficiency, when the severe protein deficiency occurs in dog, that leads to poor food intake, growth retardation or weight loss, muscle wasting, emaciation, and death may occur due to deficiency of severe protein. And less severe deficiency when occurs, then rough and dull hair coat, compromised immune system, very much important, compromised immune system due to deficiency of protein, and poor milk production in reproductive ages occurs. During a stress condition, the protein requirement may increase. And if diet containing more protein, sometimes the pet owner fed more nutritious diet, or they are providing more protein for getting better performance, then under such condition, the extra protein that metabolized and used for the energy source. And you know about the gluconeogenesis. By that way, the protein source can be metabolized and used as a source of energy. So I was talking about the cat. The deficiency of amino acid or even single amino acids, that leads to health problem in case of cat. So amino acid and protein requirement is very much important in case of cat. And when we talk about the arginine, which is vital for the many of the animals for performing the different function, chemical functions, and without arginine, the entire system goes affected. So when we talk about the dog, they're not so sensitive to arginine, but cat are very much sensitive to arginine, because dog can produce enzymes that support the production of arginine inside the body, but cat cannot do this. And cat are extremely sensitive to the arginine, and due to the deficiency of arginine, because they are unable to synthesize the arginine inside the body. And arginine is a critical, arginine amino acid, which is becomes critical to remove ammonia from the body. Arginine is very much critical to remove ammonia from the body through urine. And without sufficient amount of arginine inside the body or in the diet of the cat, which may suffer from the toxic building up of ammonia in the bloodstream. So ammonia toxicity may occurs due to deficiency of arginine. That is why arginine is very much essential for cat, and dog can synthesize arginine inside the body whatever they required, but cat cannot. Like taurine, taurine is also dietary essential in case of cat. And deficiency of taurine, which leads to retinal degeneration. And due to retinal degeneration, blindness may occur. Deafness, they also cause, the deficiency of taurine also cause deafness, cardiac problem, immune response, the failure of immune response or inadequate immune response, poor neonatal growth, reproductive failure, and congenital defects. So these are the features of these are the deficiency symptoms or deficiency cause of taurine. And the source of taurine is red meat, fishes, whatever the fish is available, red meat, small rodents, birds, these are the source of taurine. So a strict vegetarian diet are not suitable for cat, always. Cat, because the source is non-veg or taurine. So when we feed a strict vegetarian diet to the cat, they always deficient in taurine, and several consequences occur due to the deficiency of taurine. One important thing I would like to say, that the cat uses 20% of protein for growth and metabolism. They use 20% of protein for growth and metabolism, and 12% for maintenance. However, dogs use 12% of protein for growth and metabolism, and 4% for maintenance. So now coming to the fat requirement in pet animals. So fat are concentrated or densified form of energy, and fat digestion is more complex when compared with the protein and carbohydrate. However, the dog, healthy dog and cat, they can digest fat very efficiently, which is available in the diet of the pet. So digestibility of fat is very efficient, and they can digest up to even 95% of the fat. So there are three basic essential fatty acids which are being required for pet, and that are, you all are aware about the essential fatty acids, like linoleic acid, linolenic acid and arachidonic acids. So these three essential fatty acids are required for pet. And one of the essential fatty acids, like linoleic acid, the source is fat, and which is essential for dog to maintain the good skin coat, good hair coat, that means body coat. And they are also carrier for fat soluble vitamins. So fat are also contributing to enhance the palatability of food. And when food contains or ration contains too less amount of the fat, then there may be the development of, or there may be the chance to develop coarse hair, dry, thick skin, itching problem, damaging of the cells, and a skin lesion may appear. So fat is also very much important, that should be included in the diet of the pet. When we talk about the cat, cat are unable to convert linoleic acid and linolenic acid into arachidonic acid due to lack of enzymes. Which enzymes? Lack of delta 6 desaturase enzymes. So they cannot convert the linoleic acid to arachidonic acid due to lack of these enzymes. So we should provide the source, dietary source, or synthetic form of arachidonic acid to the cat diet. And deficiency of essential fatty acid, that shows the dull, scuffy coat, hair loss in pet, fatty liver, एनीमिया, इम्पेयर्ड फर्टिलिटी, रिप्रोडक्टिव फेलियर में आकर एंड डिफिशियंसी ऑफ फैट सॉल्युबल विटामिन बिकॉज दे आर कैरियर. नाउ कमिंग टू द मिनरल्स, व्हाट आर द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ मिनरल्स इन पेट एनिमल्स. सो minerals which plays very important or significant role in metabolism, and due to deficiency of minerals, different minerals, the metabolism may be affected in the body, and once metabolism get affected, there is the symptom arises, deficiency of minerals, and several problems starts occurring. So mineral is very much important in case of PET. Like that, we talk about vitamins. Like minerals, vitamin is also very much essential in the diet, and fat soluble vitamin, water soluble vitamin, and both are equally essential. And when the insufficient vitamin levels in the diet, they decrease or diminishes the immune system of the body. They cause gums problem. They reduce the ability to acquire energy from the digested food. And excess water soluble vitamins that can be excreted from the body. But if excess fat soluble vitamin, if we offer in the diet, then there may be the chance of causing toxicity or poisoning of vitamins. So we should take care while we are feeding or offering any supplements to the pet. Now coming to the water requirement. What are the requirement of water and how we can feed the water to the pet? So water requirement is totally depend on the amount of food consumes, how much amount of the food we are offering to the pets. That depends, that food are depends, water are depends on that requirement of the food. And generally in common principle, 1 ml of water for each kilocalorie of energy is required. 1 ml of water for each kilocalorie. That means if 1000 kilocalories, suppose 1000 kilocalories per day required by the pet, then 1000 ml of water, that means 1 liter of water should be required for such pet. And water intake also increases when the food intake increases. So they are directly proportional. Water requirement is directly proportional to the food intake. However, water content of a diet increase when any food, those food which contains high amount of the moisture. Under such condition, the animal drinks less water. That means water requirement will be less in such condition. And water, there are several functions of the water. As we know that water assists in the maintaining body temperature, blood formation, body fluid, maintenance of body fluid, prevent dehydration. So these are the common function of the water. And if any deficiency of water occurs, then these functions will be affected. These features will be affected and animal get dehydrated and several problems occurs. So to avoid this, we should always provide clean and fresh water all the time to our pets. So now coming to the nutrient requirement for dogs and cats. As per Association of American Feed Control Officials, the requirement of dog and cat. They have divided the dog into two stage, growth and reproduction, and second stage is adult maintenance. Similarly, in case of cat also. So, protein requirement in case of dog for growth and reproduction is 22%. Adult maintenance, minimum protein requirement in case of dog is 18%. In case of cat, the protein requirement under growth and reproduction is 30%. It is quite high. The protein requirement is higher than the dog. It is quite high in case of cat. That is 30% minimum protein requirement under growth and reproductive condition. And adult maintenance, 26% protein will be required in case of cat. Fat percentage is required in case of dog under growth and reproduction, 8%, and adult 5% fat. However, in case of cat, 9%, and adult maintenance also 9% fat. Linoleic acid requirement in case of dog is 1% both stage, and in case of cat 0.5% in both stage. Arachidonic acid requirement is not required in case of dog, because they synthesize the arachidonic acid from the linoleic acid and linoleic acid. However, in case of cat, arachidonic acid should be required, like 0.02% in both stages. Vitamin A requirement in case of dog is 5000 international unit, but in case of cat, the requirement is very high, 9000 under growth and reproduction stage, and adult maintenance 5000. Taurine requirement is not required in case of dog, but in case of cat, taurine is required, 0.1 to 0.2% in both the stages of the cat. Calcium requirement is again 1.1% in case of growth and reproduction in dog, and 0.6% in adult. And similar requirement almost in case of the cat, calcium. And phosphorus requirement in both dog and cat is required similarly, at 0.9% and 0.5%. So these are the nutrient requirement as per the Association of American Feed Control and Officials for cat and dog. And we should prepare the ration or feed kept in mind that these are the requirement and these are the stage of the pets. So now coming to the factors which affect the nutritional requirement in pets. There are different factors, several factors which affect the nutrient requirement of pets. And for optimum nutrition, the key element which is raising a healthy dog or cat. What are the key elements for rearing or keeping healthy pet? And these factors are very common factors: breed, variation, breed, age, gender. Gender means male, female, either intact or spayed or neutered. Or physiological state. Or physiological state. Under physiological state, growth, adult. Under adult, either pregnant or lactating in case of female. Senior pet, geriatric pet, that means old age pet, body weight and composition, activity level or environment. Activity level, that means show dog, guard dog, working dog, hunting dog, racing dog. So these are the activity of the pets. that will affect the nutrient requirements. Or nutrient requirement will vary according to the activity. And environmental factor also may affect, like cold weather, hot weather, rainy season. They may affect humidity condition. They may affect the nutrient requirement accordingly. And lastly, stress and health condition of the pets. That very much affect the nutrient requirement. So these are different factors which affect the nutrient requirements, and I would like to discuss one by one of each factors. So first factor is breed. Breed means if we talk about the same breed of similar size and weight, they can differ greatly in their energy requirement. So this is very much important, and higher ratio of body fat to lean muscle mass. When we talk about the higher ratio of body fat to lean muscle mass, like Beagle, a small breed, Labrador, larger than Beagle, Golden Retriever, it is larger than Labrador. So like that, when we compare, they affect the nutrient requirement, and nutrient requirement depends on the breed variation. And a small breed that grows up to around 25 to 30 times greater than their birth weight. So the requirement will be more, or food requirement will be more for a smaller breed per kg of body weight than compared to the larger breed. Like examples, less than 10 kg of the body weight, they require 50 kilocalorie metabolizable energy per kg of body weight per day. Between 10 to 20 kg body weight, they require 30 to 40 kilocalorie metabolizable energy per kg of body weight per day, and greater than 20 kg, they require 20 to 30 kilocalorie metabolizable energy per kg of body weight per day. So like that, breed may affect the requirement of nutrients. Secondly, age. So not all breeds that mature at same rate. So there is variation in the maturity, getting maturity, and this variation may affect the nutrient requirements. And this is one of the important parameters which affect the nutrient requirement. And nutritional need of maintaining a healthy pet, we should offer according to the age or their growth. So we should keep in mind that we have to feed the animal, we have to feed our pets according to the age, and there is variation in the nutrients as per the age. Next point is the gender. These factors, gender means the male are usually or required greater amount of energy source because they have greater amount of the muscle mass when compared with the female, and male expend more energy per kg body weight in comparison with the female. And male are generally, they have less tendency to become overweight or obese when compared with the female. So, or when we can say that the spaying or neutering a pet, that may leads to gaining body weight. So these are the associated factors under the genders which affect the nutrient requirement of the nutrients of the pets. Next factor is the physiological stage of the pet. And when compared to the adult dog, the growing puppy requires 2 to 4 times more energy per kg body weight 2 to 4 times more energy per kg body weight growing puppy requires when compared with the adult dog. And when puppy approaches adulthood, the energy requirement is reduced. So when age is increasing, the energy requirement will be reduced accordingly. And the similarly, for reproductive female, the energy requirement at the end of gestation and early lactation phase, the requirement is 2 to 4 times higher in comparison with the adult maintenance requirement. So the physiological stage of the life of the pet will affect the nutrient requirement, and nutrient requirement will be vary according to the physiological state of the pet. Next factor is body weight and composition. That means the body weight, which is the primary factor, and we are formulating the ration, we are formulating the feed according to the body weight of the animals. So body weight is the primary factors, and the level of energy required as per the body weight. And body weight composition decides the amount of fat tissue carried by animals. However, the greater the ratio of fat to muscle, that means fat to muscle ratio is greater, then the lower the amount of calorie needed per kg of body weight. Health status of dog or cat, which can determine by its body condition score. So pet owner, if they record the body condition score, they can judge the health status of their pet. So it is very much important to know the body condition score of the pet. Now next factor is the activity level. So activity is the second most important factor after body weight, and which determining the dietary needs of the healthy pets. So what kind of activity they are doing which determine the nutrient requirements. Generally overweight dog and cats, how this overweight of dog and cat happens, how they are gaining more weight, because they are doing less exercise, and due to inadequate exercise they get more deposition of the fat inside the body, so they get overweight. And when exceeding the routine exercise, the energy needs can rise rapidly. So when performing some work or doing more vigorous exercise, the requirement of energy will be more for such particular pets. Next factor is stress. This is very much important, and a stress which is set of response that can occurs due to any extra demand, either physical or emotional. So in early physiological response, what happens during a stress, in early physiological response, there is increase in heart rate, heartbeat, the stomach looks constriction of the stomachs, and energy or mobilization of energy source. So these three things occurs when animals are under a stress. And during a stress, which stimulates the release of adrenaline. Adrenaline will be released during